guys, welcome to episode 16 of my sorcery build, and we're going to continue with Farron Keep. So we're going to jump into where we last left off. Our first object would be to get the undead bone shard. This is where we came down the bridge, where those three enemies are. We'll just leave them be, there's no point in disturbing them. This is the door that we're going to go through eventually. As you can see, we've lit two of the flames, so we've put two towers out, and we've just the third one to light. But this is where his undead bone shard is. We've got a slug hanging on the wall. We'll take him out first. Or her. Or it. And then we've got about seven-ish inside. It is important to clear this room out as well, not only to get the undead bone shard, but it's going to protect us from two big beefy mobs that's going to try to chew us for itself. Hiding in this little building, they can't get to us. It's enough melee damage. Right. That's that first. And if I do that, these will all reset. Well, it don't matter. Okay. Change of plans. What we're going to do is take out this area first. We've got three slugs at the bottom of this ladder. In it. Up here we have a mini boss, some mobs, three crystal lizards, four crystal lizards actually, because there's one just before we go in, before we go further up the tower. Got a bonfire, and you've got a wolf covenant, is it? We don't want to join it just yet, but if you pray at it, you will get the emote. Beer. Only way to get to it is an illusionary wall. Watch for crystal lizard as well. Just have a quick run round. No, didn't think there were. Right, that illusionary wall. And it's not marked up. don't know why. Somebody had marked it up, so we'll put a message down and mark it up for people. Is this the one? Been that long since, yeah. Been that long since I did it. And then people know. There might be some newbies playing who don't know. Also get a good view of the surrounding area up here. If you do get lost. It'll be able to see which way to go, but the bonfire is. The tower, should I say. Right. Okay, that's the mini boss. Don't worry about it, we're gonna cheese it. But first we're gonna go this way. Three crystal lizards to take out. If we can get them all in one go. Two really near each other. The potential of both running together. Yep, got them both. Right. Get these two drops up. Lightning Spear, one of the cleric's favourites. Dragon Crest Shield. What we'll do, we'll have a look at his shields while we're here. Because there should be somewhat better now. Naturally you want physical at 100%. As you can see, that Dragon Crest shield, it puts everything up for us. Right, your next crystal lizard is up here. You can just see it. Okay, it's a tendency to run up them steps. We don't want it to if we can avoid it, but here we go. Because it runs straight past all mobs. Gonna go up here because he screamed and got them all et up. Nasty. Take these out first. They're not firing arrows at us while we're baiting other people. Do the dance. Yep. Oh. once this area cleared. Nah, it's a mini-boss. Be careful how you get down here, you can kill yourself if you don't. Make sure you drop on the towers. So we're going to kite it back to this tower. Again, you have to be past us, it will reset back to over there. Got to do some damage on it. Alright, come at us. Come on. Baiting us in closer. Maybe just gonna stand there. Well, that's a burst for me. Probably remembers me from last time. I think it's not worth chasing. There you go. So you see, one of his messages was rated, so I've only put one message down so far. That illusionary wall one. When somebody rates your message, it fills your health back up for you. And we'll head back down. We'll rely on flasks. We're okay. Did we? Yeah, we activated the bonfire. Or did we sit at it though? Nope, don't look like it. So there shouldn't be any slugs at the bottom of here. Which is good. Okay. Here's his house. And we're going to follow up bonfires now. We've got two. Take the slugs out. We've got two biggies coming up. In fact, you can see it walking at the top right hand of the screen. They do a dark attack, a casting dark attack, and they'll say melee damage. The dark attack can get you in that house if you're not careful. But if you keep yourself positioned far enough away, the melee won't hit you. And again, good old trusty bow and arrow. It can run quite quick in this swamp, this one. And it has tendency to go back, so keep an eye on it. That's the spells I were on about, so be careful of it. And we have to do that all again, but this time it's further to run. Let's get these drops while we're here. So there's one to the third bonfire, but we need to take this mob out first. I can see him. It's there. Okay. Looks like he's reset. See if we can... Yeah, we can. Let's give him another one just for good luck. Still coming at us? Yeah, he is. God, his wheels.
Mm-hmm.
away a bit. And then we'll unleash shell. There you go. I believe there's a face hugger on this one just to make it that extra bit difficult. Sure there were a face hugger. Jump out at me, I'm telling you. So the third light. That out should light the bowl and the door should open. This face sugar, there is a face sugar here, I'm not sure of it. Well, must be wrong. Actually he's up there. But he can stop up there, for the time being. Okay, I think I should ember up here. And that way we can be invaded by Yellow Finger. I think he's come round here, this area. I might be wrong. I to poison drop down a bit. Okay, whenever head over there, get the drop there that's next to the Estus Soul. So if you blow an elf, you can drink that. Drop here. Well, I don't know where Yellowfinger's gone to. He must be scared to come and attack me. Okay. Let's head back over to the bonfire. Poison them. Yeah, poisoned. I'm just moving around a bit, because I'm sure Yellowfinger used to invade when I used to get near this pump fire at the bottom. But we may not be numbered up. Let me just run up it, see if it activates it. No. Wonder if I go a bit this way. I don't want to get too far away from land that I could paint him on, if you know what I mean. Okay, I think what I'll do, I'll go up where the facehugger is. Because I think that's the only thing I've done different to when I last played. Let's clear all this away so we can run quite good if we need to. Put right spell on. Yeah, scratch your head. And these will be missing. And as you can see, it does quite a bit of damage. And right on kill, here is Yellowfinger. That's the only thing I could think of doing different, so it had to be that. Try magic at first. If you remember, we met him in Road to Sacrifice and he actually killed me this time. He has the obscuring ring on. Dirt. one more.
Yes.
Very close though. Really close that.
And it's giving me some nice shots, so it's just nice.
So guys, I think we're going to call it for this episode. I hope you've enjoyed it, gathered a bit of information from it. If you have, please hit that like button and I'll catch you next time. Bye.